In this part of the series, we will talk about finding the optimal settings in control variables so that your response variable is maximized. See, we go back to the original table that we did before. There are 9 runs and we have taken the output variables and that table. And here in this slide, you will see a table, smaller table at the lower part of the slide. Now, in this table, what we are trying to do is we are trying to enter average value of Z. Average value of Z, where A, B, C and D are taken, each of them, A is low, medium, high, B is low, medium, high, C is also similar. So, you have 4 into 3, 12 numbers to be entered in the lower table. Now, look at the number 68.79, A low, that cell we are talking about, it is also shaded in gray. Now, how do we find this 68.79? You go to the upper table, you consider the output where A is 1. And you can see it shaded in the upper table. So, all the numbers from 76 to 75, that is G14 cell to N16 cell, the numbers that are shaded there, those numbers if you average out, then that value is 68.79. So, we will have to evaluate, or you will have to enter all these 12 numbers depending on in a similar way. So, I will just explain one more cell just to give you an idea. So, idea is that in that lower table, so we have to fill in 4 into 3, 12 numbers. I have just explained how this 68.79 number has been obtained. It has been obtained by averaging out the shaded portion in the upper table. So, I will go to another cell. Now, in this, we are trying to evaluate what happens when B is medium. So, you can see 71.54 is the number. How are we getting that number? We are getting that number by averaging out the shaded portion. How are we choosing the shaded portion? You can see that the shaded portion is only selected based on when B is 2. 2 is medium. When B is 2, you can see one set of numbers. There are 3 rows that are being averaged. The first row is G15 to N15. This is one row. G18 to N18. This is another row. And G21 to N21 is another row. All these shaded numbers, if you average out and put it in a cell where B is medium. So, you can see it is shaded there, 71.54. Likewise, all these 12 cells have to be entered with the respective average Z, average Z. Now, if I consider the lower table, once it is fully done, if I consider this lower table in the final shape, after we have entered all these 12 numbers, it looks like this. There are 4 variables A, B, C and D, and each of these variables have low, medium and high. We have put in all these numbers after calculating the values from my experiment. Now, you can see in the A column, if I consider the A column only, I can see that the maximum value of Z comes up only when Z is only when A is medium. A is medium, then the value 75.54 is the maximum in that column. Similarly, for B column, we see that when B is low, that is yielding a maximum average Z, 74.63. Similarly, for D, it is coming to 74.5, which is the maximum in column C. 74.33 is the maximum in column D. So, this tells me that my optimal result of z will come up when I keep a as medium, b as low, c as high and d as low. If I use this combination in my control variables, my prediction is that my output will be optimized. So, I will just summarize the finding here. Combination of controllable variables yielding best predicted result. So, where is my best predicted result? My best predicted result is when A is medium, level 2, B is low, which is level 1, C is high, which is level 3, and D is low, which is level 1. Now, this particular combination 2, 1, 3, 1, you will notice that it is not part of my original experiment. That is, I had 9 runs in which I had chosen a combination of A and B and C and D. You will see that 2, 1, 3, 1 was not part of my 9 runs, but yet I am able to predict that this particular combination 2, 1, 3, 1 will give me the best possible output. So, this is the finding, or this is the beauty of Taguchi experiment, that even though you have selected a small number of runs, yet you are able to predict what will give you the best possible result, even though that particular combination of variables has not been run. So, you can see that this combination, this is my original experiment, where you can see that 2, 1, 3, 1, that is A is 2, B is 1, C is 3 and D is 1 was not run. This was not part of the original experiment that I did, but yet this experiment tells me that this particular combination will give me the best possible result or maximize the output. Now, I will just talk a few things about this interaction between variables. From this experiment we can find out an interaction between variables. Just to explain this, see, we have here taken the original table, which was my experiment. This is on the top of the slide. Now, the lower left hand side, you will see that we have made a table which says interaction between control variable A and uncontrolled variable E. So, this is a table that we are trying to make, in which we are again, let us say when A is low and E is low. So, this is the cell that we want to evaluate. So, you can see that it is painted in green, and to come to that figure of 70.17, what we have to do is to look at the table above, see the green portion and take an average value of the green portion. So, you take all the figures shown in green in the upper table, find out an average value of that and then put it in the table lower table at the place where A is low and E is low. Similarly, let's take another example that we are looking at a figure in orange colored cell where A is medium and E is high. So, orange colored figure, colored cell, 79.5. So, how are we coming to that figure? You go to the upper table, you look at the cells which are orange in color. So, those are the ones which we will take and find an average and put it in this cell. So, likewise, we will try to fill in all these six cells. Now, we are trying to establish or find out an interaction between a controlled variable, which is in my hand, and an uncontrolled variable E, which in the production process will not be in my hand. But still, we are from this controlled experiment, we are trying to find out whether there is an interaction between A and E. So, now with these values, if I try to plot a graph, so the graph will look something like this. So, at the x-axis, you will find E is plotted, where there are two points, either E can be low or E can be high, and you have the red line, you have the blue line, and also the black line. The red line tells me this is the medium A. When A is medium, this is the line that you get. All these lines you are getting from the interaction table which we just drew up. So you can see that there is an interaction between the variables. What I mean by interaction is that the lines are kind of crossing each other. So when this is going high, the other is trying to take it down. So this gives me an idea of the kind of interaction. Now, just to give you an idea of what is the graph looking like when I say that there is no interaction. Just to take an hypothetical example, this is not the result of this experiment, but just to show you what the graph looks like when two variables do not interact with each other. In the case of no interaction, the graph would look something like this. It will be kind of parallel lines. So this shows that there is no interaction between the two variables that we are considering. Whereas the earlier graph showed interaction, this graph says that these two variables do not interact. So, by carrying out this kind of an experiment, we are in a position to find out which variables are interacting with each other, which variables are not interacting with each other, which is the optimal combination of variables which is likely to give me the optimal or the result that I desire. So, this is the experiment and this is the topic which I wanted to cover. Thank you.